everybody, welcome back to Northern Lions Hard Mode, Binding of Isaac Rebirth Runs. We're gonna random, we did unlock some stuff in red here as Isaac last time. Feel pretty much like a big idiot for the way that, oh, a cane this time, huh? I feel pretty much like a big idiot for the way that I, unfortunately went to the wrong area last time, but that's okay, you know? You live and learn, that's what Canadian pop princess Alanis Morissette said. YWEK. WHGT. Why Home and Garden Television? Why YWEK? Let's begin. Kane! I can't really say anything positive about you, my friend. Hard mode, apparently the biggest change between normal mode and hard mode seems to be that in hard mode you fight Super Wrath on the first or second floor every single time. But maybe he gives me a bomb item, I was gonna say. He just gave me a bomb. That's alright. Maybe one good thing about Kane that I can admit readily here is that he does start with a key, which means that, you know, we're at least going to get to an item room on the next floor. And that's an important one. The item room on the second floor is, like, pretty principal to the whole operation. Get something good in the first floor, get something good on the second floor, and all of a sudden you're rolling, partner. You know what time it is. I don't know. Could be various different times depending on where you are in the world right now. That's pretty crazy. You know, I was like 15. I was like, why doesn't the world just get rid of fucking time zones? Oh, technology is not that good. We have Curse of the Maze here. And you realize, like, oh no! Let me out! You realize the time zones actually have, like, a pretty principal kind of goal. Would you want to be, like, a farmer in one part of the world where, you know, I guess it would just change your work hours. I don't know. What I'm getting at is that it was selfish of me to even suggest it, but now I can't even understand why. So our Tinted Rock situation did work out here. It wasn't as difficult as I thought it was, but it certainly wasn't as easy as just, you know, your average Tinted Rock pickup. Everyone, raise your rock pickups in chat. That's, of course, Nick's emoticon that is a Ford F-150, the best-selling truck in North America, last 23 years running. I don't know anything. You gotta, if you want to get that shit sorted out, you gotta talk to JD Power and Associates. Now, I don't love being on the cellar on the first floor. I'll give you that. Means we might have to deal with the haunt. No, instead we're gonna be dealing with famine, which actually, I think I mentioned this in like two episodes ago, but I'm pretty excited about actually having to fight haunts, or sorry, fight famine, because it does give me the faintest glimmer in the back of my mind that we may have a small chance to actually become, not become, but to get a third level Meat Boy. Which would be amazing! Like, I keep saying it, but really, I think it is gonna be one of the last things we unlock, so that's why I'm, you know, bringing it to your attention, but it's so much more difficult to become Meat Boy now for a variety of different reasons. Big one being, Book of Revelations, I think, is a little bit less effective. Like, it only gives you a chance to get a horseman on, like, half of the floors. Like, you can only get one horseman on the basement, one horseman on the caves, something like that. And additionally, you can get the bandage items from the horseman instead. So I really do think that that's going to be one of the last things we end up actually accomplishing in the game. Which is fine, you know. We'll get a handle on it regardless. There's our item room. No bombs, which means that we are pretty much on our own when it comes to things like Spirit Hearts. We pretty much just gotta really try not to take any damage on the rest of this floor. We can take one hit of damage against an enemy that does a half heart. That'll give us a deal with the devil. Hopefully we get some HP from the boss. Or we could just get some HP right here. That doesn't bother me either. Lard is basically an HP doubling for me right now. And I don't think it comes with a corresponding speed downgrade anymore. Which is pretty exciting as well. Don't love these flies, but this run's shaping up to be half decent. I'll readily admit that I don't like the fact that we don't have any other consumables at all here, but hey, thus far, I don't think I can be too salty about this. Monstro, relatively easy boss fight. Maybe, a lot of people might argue that Monstro is like the easiest boss fight that you could possibly get at this point. Just want to get a little bit of extra orbital damage done in there. Okay, that was a dumb decision on my part. Now we've really gotta try to not take damage. This deal with the devil, especially now that we've gotten lard, could be a gift from the heavens. Mom's knife, brimstone, many different options. We're stuck with the screw, which is actually alright. I don't want to say anything bad about this room until after it's gone, but fudge, I hate me some deals with the devil that don't actually give you items. I get that it's a balancing agent, and it helps keep the runs in the game from looking too samey, you know? It's no longer just get that first deal with the devil snag like Mom's Knife, Spirit of the Night, the Pact, the Mark, etc., etc. But still, it's very disappointing when you give it your all and you meet the criteria, and then you end up not being able to get a deal with the devil regardless, really. But extra spirit hearts does give us a better chance of securing those deals in the future. There's a tinted rock there. I didn't notice that before. Mind you, it's kind of all intellectual right now because we don't have any bombs. But if we get bombs, we could turn those bombs into spirit hearts, keys, or bombs, or any combination thereof. Another not super fantastic room. I'd heard that, a lot of people are rubbed the wrong way by hard mode because it's basically just, like, less consumable rich, so you end up skipping a bunch of item rooms. That would indeed make the game harder. We didn't really notice that in our last run. We got kind of lucky in that regard, but I'm starting to notice it on this run. That's for dang sure. All right. Not as scary on that room as I thought it would be. Two bombs. That's pretty okay. Oh, we should get that red heart. We're actually in a pretty good position here. If we could just snag, like, one pretty good offensive item. If we could just get a little bit of help from the game, like maybe they could drop Mom's Knife and Polyphemus for us on the next floor. Maybe a free ability to fly. I'm thinking you throw in a Sacred Heart from a golden chest and then, you know, Gnawed Leaf or something like that. Just something to keep my hopes up here. All right, we got a bomb and a Spirit Heart, which is a pretty good deal. I mean, it's objectively a great deal, but at the same time, kind of annoying. Well, we might as well blow these up to get this bomb, just to see if maybe there was a black market or something. It's one of those things that I'm starting to try to, I wouldn't say min-max, but, you know, if you have the opportunity to trade one for one and it's a guarantee, you could get a little bit more out of it, so you might as well give it a shot. All right, catacombs. My only goal for this floor is that we pick up a key. If we pick up a key, If we pick up a key, even if our item room ends up being shitty, I don't care. At least we got the chance to look into it. Now, with as many bombs as we have a pretty decent chance, I'd say, of being able to bomb our way through the secret room into the shop or the item room. No guarantees, of course, but could happen. Now, if you guys could just... Yeah, thank you. Thank you. This room becomes a lot easier once everything opens itself up a little bit. Present yourself like a debutante at the debutante's ball. What an elegant reference, Northern Lion. The debutante's ball. Well, that's true. I am the reincarnated form of a 19th century Prussian diplomat. There's actually, I'm trying to think of who. I don't think it was Teddy Roosevelt, but there's like a famous figure from relatively recent history who thought that he was, like, the reincarnated form of, like, a Prussian general or something like that. And would oftentimes, like, you know, go into these weird, like, psychotic episodes or fugue states where he would speak in German. And if anyone knows what I'm talking about, because I recognize that this is a very vague reference that I've made there. But if you know what I'm talking about, you leave a comment and let me know. That's how you know that I'm scumming you up for comments and likes and stuff like that, right? Typical YouTube. If you know the name of the diplomat who thought he was a Prussian general, leave a comment. If your favorite German diplomat of all time is Otto von Bismarck, make sure to leave a like. What can I say? You know, I'm a little scummy like that. I know that the people love one thing, and that thing is, late 19th, early 20th century German diplomacy. It's just something they always have, they always will. We just got lard twice in the same run. Which, I'm not complaining, don't get me wrong. But, especially now that it doesn't come with a speed downgrade, I'm extremely happy to have, oh my god. Well, at least we're not fighting a champion anymore. The champions on hard mode supposedly are not any more likely to drop consumables, by the way, so that's fine by me. Or they're not as likely to drop consumables as champions in a vanilla game, at least. I'm not 100% sure about that. That's just what I've heard. That was not a very good place for me to stand against these dangles. At least we have, like, a kind of penetrative shot. So even though we're not dealing a whole heck of a lot of damage, we're still holding steady here. Like Craig Finn. Not a very good performance there. Please. I beg you, just one key. Even if we don't get a key, I'll still feel pretty good about this run, I think, because we should get a deal with the devil or angel. Not sure which one, because we didn't get a real deal with the devil on our last opportunity. We should get some kind of deal after our next floor, but, you know, not being able to go to item rooms is one of the leading causes of shitty runs. I don't work for the American Medical Association, but if I had to say, I would say that approximately 69% of shitty runs are caused by having to skip item rooms. So it's got a big coincidence with that. But we did get our key. That's a really good item for us, honestly. Gives us an ability to generate consumables, particularly spirit hearts. We'll have the ability to see the map, which does... I think Crystal Ball shows you the first secret room, but not the second. At least that's how it was in vanilla. That's a pretty good item for us. Do we have a battery on this floor, too? No, that was the last floor. Okay. Well, I am going to go to the cursed room, because, you know, basically free deal with the devil items, potentially, or potentially nothing, but it's only a spirit heart. Hey, we ended up gaining a black heart in the process. This is okay. This run is shaping up. We desperately need to improve our damage, but apart from that, it's actually going all right. So we will head our ass up here. I was trying to think of something creative about our character here, but I don't know. It's just a jumbled mess of disaster here. It's a shame that Kane doesn't start with, effectively, the PhD anymore, because, man, with all these mushrooms, I would love to blow those up, give ourselves a little bit of pharmaceutical loving, I think, which is also my favorite Tupac song. Tupac. Something about my pronunciation of that didn't feel right. But here we are. Alright. Oh, yeah. Sure. Why not? You know the deal. We want keys above all else. Well, no, that's not true. If you could just give me, like, a mom's knife drop, like, right out in the open, that would be sweet as heck, too. I'd turn into Joe Dirt. I'd say that is a dang good drop. Can someone tell me, am I just a snob? Don't answer that, by the way. But, are people real excited for Joe Dirt 2? Like, Joe Dirt 1. I don't think it's a very good movie. I hate that you can't criticize a movie oftentimes, by the way, without people being like, hey, you just don't know how to have fun. I hate that I put on that voice for that, by the way. But, you know, if you ever say that a stupid movie is bad, they go, oh, you take yourself too seriously. How about maybe I just don't like the freaking movie? Nobody ever says that about, like, food items. You know, oh, you don't like... lemonade? You take yourself too seriously. What are you talking about? Maybe I just don't like the taste. It's the same with movies, you know? I will say... Oh, Hierophant's a good card. I will say... Joe Dirt is probably the best thing David Spade has done in his career outside of Tommy Boy. Maybe Black Sheep. That being said, that he's not going up against very high-level competition there. He hasn't set the bar too high for himself. I think, and you know, I know there's people that love David Spade. That's totally fine. Not really my my kind of film actor, I guess. I prefer a little bit more of a Carlos Mencia. You know, Beverly Hills Chihuahua? Probably one of the best talking animal-related films of all time. I don't think there's any question about that. I believe, what was it that Roger Ebert said about Beverly Hills Chihuahua? I believe he said it's the Citizen Kane of movies. It's the Citizen Kane of talking animal movies, anyway. And I know you're going to say Air Bud 2, Golden Receiver, but it's not Air Bud 2, Golden Receiver, because Air Bud doesn't talk. I know you're going to say Dunstan Checks In. Well, how about you check out Dunstan Checks In, and you realize that, yes, he's a monkey that works in a hotel, but he doesn't speak either. Honestly, I'm starting to think that you guys are just not even doing your research. We're not having this discussion in good faith. You're bringing up movies with animals that don't even talk. Next, you're going to be saying, like, Milo and... Oh, actually, yeah, they might talk in Milo and Otis. I don't want to think about Milo and Otis. That movie... I'd probably have shed more tears in my life. Oh, that's a really good item. No deal with the devil, though. Probably shed more tears in my life due to Milo and Otis than anything else on this planet. Don't even try to tell me Milo and Otis isn't sad. It's the saddest shit of all fucking time. It's like a real, you know, coming-of-age story. In like, sixth grade, we were taking a poll of movies that we wanted to watch. Because it was like one of the end-of-class days or something like... Oh, my fudge. One of like the end, the last days of class, I should say. Anything in here? Maybe. We ended up watching Milo and Otis in a movie called, I think it's called Wild America. It has like Jonathan Taylor Thomas in it. So hot back then. Anyway, being like sixth grade, you know, in the throes of the start of puberty, watching a movie about these cute animals going through these tough situations. Bombs are key? Yeah. And try not to cry, because if you cry, that's your whole reputation just down the shitter right there, isn't it? You're the kid who, for the rest of your life, if you cry to Milo and Otis in sixth grade, that's where you're going to be for the rest of your high school career. It's like social suicide, basically, to show emotion in that age. And I didn't cry. I'm not proud to say that, though, because I should have been true to myself. But that's the way the cookie crumbled there. Lemon Party's really good, but, you know, we, unfortunately, used it. We gotta get something out of this. Demon Judgment gave us Missing Page 2, which is like, it's just not very good. We're gonna gamble a little bit here, though, because we want to earn some keys, if it's at all possible. And more red hearts wouldn't hurt, either. Seriously, like, gambling... Oh, we finally unlocked Counterfeit Penny, okay. Gambling shouldn't be less likely to pay out, right? Like, that should still have the same chance. Wheel of Fortune, we'll throw this down here. I would like to stay over 15 cents, but, you know, in the process, I would also like to earn a key so we can go to the shop, so it's kind of a moot point. Yeah, Mystery Sack, it's like, okay. Two keys, that's good. Now, we have not been to our item room yet, so we'll go to that, and then we'll go to our shop, I suppose. Why not? Alright, we'll head to our left up here, and Spider Babby. Decent item. Sissy Long Legs. It's not really called Spider Babby. I like calling it Spider Babby, though. So doesn't Sissy Long Legs just drop spiders like every time you finish a room? It's one of those new spider items that I'm not 100% sure of. So we can go BOGO Bombs or Mom's Purse. I feel weird not going with BOGO Bombs because consumables are so hard to come by, but I think I have to go Mom's Purse. There's just too many good... trinkets to not take Mom's Purse. Like, Mom's Purse, I think, has become a lot more valuable in Rebirth now that there's actually, like, a lot of trinkets that you want to... Oh, God. A lot of trinkets that you want to take. Like, I mean, not that there weren't a lot of trinkets in vanilla, but there's, a ton of good stuff. Left-hand monkey's paw, you know, various different kinds of pennies. Cancer trinket. Ooh, Judgmento. I don't know. I don't know what we do with this. I've got an idea, especially because we have the Hero Font card. I think we can get away with this. So let's try this. We're going to put Judgment down. I was actually hoping it would be a Demon Judgment, although I didn't realize until now why I was hoping that. So we can do this, and gives us many more plays. Also allows us to get into the Mob Trap room. Then we'll gamble a little bit of our money away here, hopefully in the aim of getting more consumables. We can blow these up with one bomb, maybe, if we have to. Ah, come on. Alright, so put a bomb down here. Got a lot of money out of that. That's pretty good. Got some bombs back. We'll talk to you in a little bit there, Demon Judgment Blood Bank combination. But first we're going to come down to our mob or a boss trap room. We've got our Hero Font card here to back us up if we need it. Well, bad start. Come on. Got some spiders. The spiders are going to do some okay damage, even if it's not, you know, that impressive because we have, because we have technology which is not, you know, superb on a per-tier level. I'm happy with this. I hope one of those is full health, by the way. That would give us some potential, like, huge coups. That is not very good. Okay. Am I going to take this? Let's take it. Tears up. Hey, that's good, too. We are going to be firing a little bit faster now. Technology does synergize really well with stuff like Tears upgrades. Let's pop the Hero Font down so we have that. And we're going to take Lemon Party with us and hopefully use it on the boss on the next floor. We are so freaking due for a deal with the devil, by the way. Sure. Where's my deals at? That's all I'm trying to say. No red hearts sitting around. But I really don't want to give up on this whole... That's not the... Well, it could be the right direction if I wanted to use another bomb. I don't want to give up on what I got going on here with that Demon Judgment Blood Bank combo. Is there a red heart up here? I can't help but feel like this is a pretty serious moment in this run. Hopefully there's at least one red heart for sale in our shop. We'll get our money's worth out of it. There is. Well, we're definitely going to get our money's worth out of it. That's another tiers upgrade. No, that's another lemon party. Okay. Which is fine, don't get me wrong. That is a pretty sweet option for us if we could actually hold two pills, but we can't. So, we can hold two trinkets, though. Almost walked over that spike for the third time, at which point I would expect to be publicly drawn and quartered. Come on. Blood bag. Blood bag. Oh, okay. At least we got, I think it's speedball. Yeah. But at least we got something out of that, that demon judgment. I actually have a decent amount of money as well. So we're heading down to the next floor, and we are in a little bit of a, dire strait. We got money for nothing, but we've also got no HP. I've got no dang HP. Seriously, though. We're gonna need some red hearts if we're gonna win this run. But, Crystal Bow, that's pretty good. Curse of the Unknown means we can't see our HP, which is a little bit danger-inducing here. But as long as we play our cards right, like, here's my defense mechanism for Curse of the Unknown. Don't take damage. I mean, it's a little easier said than done to just be like, hey, here's how I do well in the Binding of Isaac. Don't get hit. But pretty much, I don't have to worry about, you know, keeping track of what's going on. So, Breath of Life is, like, actually straight up terrible. I'm not gonna go for a Mega Satan kill here, by the way. Don't be ridiculous. Like, we are not in that kind of position where we can be saying that that's a reasonably good choice for us. But at least we know now that we should not be expecting any major kind of moves out of a... Oh, that was really bad. Any major kind of moves from our deal with the Angel. It's bad. If we hit a D6... Oh, it doesn't really affect us. If we had a D6, I would probably actually want to fight the Angel. Because that would give me a reasonably good chance of getting... Well, I'd get the key piece, and then I could reroll it into whatever the F I wanted to reroll it into, you know? But since we do not have a D6... That's going to be that, basically. Spirit Heart is pretty valuable here. I got hit a few more times than I'd like to admit. Spiders are helping me out. I like these spiders a lot. You guys are the heroes of this run right now, especially if we could pick up, wait for it, BFF. You know what I'm talking about, Twitch chat. BFF has overnight, for no reason, become the most popular item in the game because of that one, well, for my audience at least, because of that one time that I didn't pick it up. Which, you know, if you have to ask, you need to realize that that's just, Twitch chat works in mysterious ways, man. Why is BFF one of the most mundane shop items, now one of the most, you know, most requested options? Because that's just how it is, man. Better to use two bombs to get into our shop here. We're actually doing some decent damage, if I do say so myself. If our damage was a 2008 horror film set in a narrow series of caves, it would be the decent. That's all I'm saying about that. Piggy bank. Sure, why not? And then I'm thinking that what we end up doing is probably as soon as our crystal ball gets charged again, we just get the battery one more time. Although we're probably close to the HP cap battery-wise, so... Or not battery-wise, we're probably close to the HP cap spirit heart-wise, so I don't think it's that pressing of a concern. I think we're gonna fight the boss right away just because there's no reason not to that I can come up with. That gurgling drew a little wee-wee on the ground there. I don't know if I'm okay with that. This is a family-friendly stream, that's why I exclusively say the F-word. You know what's funny is, I was looking back... Because occasionally, the success on YouTube doesn't always come... That was really bad. Well, it doesn't always come, yeah, but... Well, sometimes not at all. Doesn't always come from the most likely scenarios. One of my most viewed videos of all time is actually... My Let's Look At, which is like a first impression style series that I do to say whether or not I like a game that I'm playing, of Wipeout 3, you know, the game show. I don't even want... Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Purity Rune, that gives us a Spirit Heart. think I'm just going to leave, because we don't want anything to do with the battery. So I think we just go down to the next floor, which means I should not, by the way, have used... We'll use this... Oh, man, that... Does that clear your curses, too? If so, that's actually pretty dang cool, but, yeah, it's my Let's Look at a Wipeout 3, which is kind of like, it's a game show, it's Ninja Warrior, basically. Or Most Extreme Elimination Challenge, depending on, you know, which one you're familiar with. The show is kind of family-friendly, you know, it's a little bit good, wholesome fun, you know, just watch a bunch of people get ridiculed about their appearance and then fall down. That's just good, wholesome entertainment there. So many of the comments on that episode reflect the average age of the people that would actually buy Wipeout 3 for the Wii U home entertainment console. The top comments are all, and now it's going to be even worse because people are going to be self-aware about it, but the top comments are almost all, stop swearing so much. Stop swearing so much. I don't want to hear the S word. And I'm like, what the... Man, that is... unexpected, let's put it that way. But I think, like, you know... I'm gonna use a key actually here to see what this is. Rules card. Chubb dislikes smoke. I don't know what that means, but at least we've had it and we've used it and we'll live and learn maybe what that does in the future. You know that it's just funny is what it is. Okay, that's what. Just surprising to me. Ooh, sad onion is actually pretty okay. We're gonna be firing like crazy now. Hopefully we have, like, for all the complaints that I can give about somewhat bad luck that we've had, like our demon judgment paying out with missing page 2, for example, or only getting 2 deals. One deal just gave me spirit hearts, the other deal gave me breath of life, which is, as I understand it, largely a mostly worthless item, in popular consideration at least. But we've had some good luck with our technology and our tiers upgrades and all of that jazzmatazz, you know? Pretty lucky in that regard. Piggy bank is gonna get us effing rich here. We're gonna have stacks on stacks. We're gonna have DJ Khaled money. Hopefully. Man, this thing just never pays out, huh? I'm not worried about our HP because we do have the spirit hearts backing us up. We got the crystal bow. We got all sorts of good, interesting stuff happening here. And remember, like our, if I may say myself here, my standards for this run, for what I would consider success, are a little relaxed based on the fact that to unlock new stuff, we only have to beat Mom's Heart. Now, I would like to go even further than that, of course, but we don't need to necessarily go further than that to make anything happen. Our DPS is, like, it's pretty solid now. We hit multiple enemies with one hit, if there's multiple enemies to hit. That speed downgrade is actually pretty bad. How fitting that you get that from fighting Lust, like one of the enemies on the game for whom it's most important to have a speed upgrade. Or have decent speed. Maybe not necessarily a speed upgrade. Not a spirit heart. But that's okay because we got the Sun card, which is probably preferable. Yeah, we'll gamble on this bad boy right here. Probably preferable. I know what you're saying, I could just use the Sun card right now and then take Lemon Party with me. I'm not gonna do that though. Even though it could give me the opportunity to gamble a little bit, you know? Well, that was not very good damage on my part, but we also effed Chubb's life up, so I'm okay with that. We'll just come back, get our Sun card, and we'll carry this with us, and no matter when we have to use it, that's fine, you know? I forgive myself. I'm going to save some money in case we come across regular judgments. It is it's known to happen. And we already donated a decent amount, so I don't feel too bad about it. Red Mom is like an ideal choice for us right now. She is not so tough. What I'm hoping for here is... that was really bad. I'm hoping for some prodigious spider generation from Sissy Short Legs here. I don't think that's the actual name, but I would like it to be. We're probably going to end up having to use the Sun card right here. My speed is so low that even when I see the foot coming, it's actually pretty hard for me to get out of the way. Yeah, here it comes. We had to use it. I'm not happy about it, but it had to be done. Hopefully we can get another one in the future. All right, there we go. Now we got to deal with the angel. We're going to take the Polaroid. Got to remember that we took the Polaroid so we, you know, don't have the same thing happen to us that happened to us last time. We get Nun's Habit, which is great. And then we're just gonna leave. I don't wanna fight that angel. Isaac, you're my angel. You're my darling angel. Closer than my peeps you are to me, baby. Whatever happened, man? Life was simpler back in 2001 when Shaggy ruled the pop charts. DAE missed 2001's music? Ja Rule was just coming out of, whatever it was that he did before he started becoming a platinum-selling recording artist. Ashanti was the hottest name on the block. J-Lo was still in her 30s. Man, those were the days. I'm being a little facetious. Just a little bit, though. One more room. And then we will figure the heck out. Whoa. One of these is turning invisible. I don't like that. I don't support that. I don't ask a lot out of the game, but if you could do me the favor of not defying the laws of optics, I would appreciate it. There is some kind of special re-rollio room over here. Scares me a little bit. I can't tell a lie. Well, I hope we get another deal with the angel opportunity. No more, please. Oh, there's one more. Okay. Maybe two more? I think that's all the wall masters. I really hope we get a deal with the angel opportunity because there's so many good angel items. Not even from like an offensive standpoint, just like defensive angel items. Sock it to me, baby. We haven't seen many of them thus far. We're not going to use any... we're going to get a second level cube of meat. Amazing. I'm not going to use any keys because I want to save them for the chest and... You know, we're pretty unlikely to find too many more over the course of this. Our DPS is actually pretty solid here. Like, we're putting out some damage that we can be relatively happy with. Largely because we're able to hit multiple targets at once. But still, that's valuable, man. Here we go, down to the next floor. I don't know how long we can kind of persist with this run, but if we live long enough to get down to the chest, at least we got something going for us. So it'll take us a room or two. Oh, crap. It'll take us a room or two, and then we'll get our... That's why I said or two. And we'll get our map layout here. We will go to the secret room, because it's a convenient location for us, right next to our house here. The most convenient location... Okie dokie. Little confused there for a minute, but that's okay. We got it sorted right out. Had a little brain fart. I don't want to teleport very much, because I know where the boss is. So I would like to, if possible, just go to the boss. Would that be plausible? Ooh, that was not too smart. I don't like the idea of fighting these double dangles here and, Mr. Big Shot dangle at the same time. I gotta move because I can't see what kind of tell he's giving me up there. Okay, that's a shot. That's all right. There we go. At least we had the advantage of distance, I guess. Relatively easy room for us in this situation. Getting close. Don't make me teleport. I'll be real ornery about that situation. I'll tell you that much. I will give you advanced warfare. Call of Duty. Advanced warning. I'll give you advanced warning that I will not be pleased if I teleport to the other side of the map anytime in the near future. I think that would be a very uncouth way of behaving and not keeping with the chivalrous attitude of the Binding of Isaac. I am going to use the crystal ball. There's arguments against it. But I'm going to use it because we're probably going to take at least a couple of hits of damage here. And that'll give us Nun's Habit, extra charges, basically. So we're probably not... And if we don't get hit, even better. But we're probably not going to end up having too many extra rooms to go to on the Cathedral. Plus, on the Cathedral, we might just guess the direction right, you know? Like, that does happen from time to time. Now, we actually have a pretty good setup for dealing with Mom's Heart. Our damage is not out of control, as you're no doubt noticing right now. But that being said, that's not that big of a deal. As long as we can do damage to multiple kind of enemies at the same time here. I know we took damage right at the very end there. I'm amazed that we only took as much damage as we did, though. Alright, spiders are getting in there. We're almost done. Do the brimstone shot. That's actually like easier to avoid, usually. Careful what you wish for there at the end, but hey, we unlocked Glass Baby. So that's at least something new. We're going up to the Cathedral here. Don't make any mistake about it. I think we got a good chance. One more room, and we'll have our... Oh, come on. I'll blow you up. One more room, and we'll have our Our Crystal Ball charge, Christian Ball. Christian Bell. Christian Bell and Christian Bell in Christian Bell. We got a Spirit Heart just randomly there. And the Empress, that's a decent card for us. We're going to just bolt across here. Need one more key. If the game would just find it in its heart to give me one more key, I would be a very happy camper. Where's he at? There we go. You know, we got infinite range. I think it'd be silly not to use it. Makes our life substantially easier. PK substantially easier. Tim the Toolman, Jonathan Taylor Thomas, goaltender for the Boston Bruins. All right, Monstro 2, let's do this shit. Let's be honest, Monstro 2, you don't have a chance in hell of killing me. You're going to die. Basically, all you can do for the rest of your life is try to please your boss, who I'm assuming in this case is actually Isaac, myself. So the best way to please Isaac, I think, would just be if you, like, laid over dead right now. Or even if you just, like, dropped a bomb that allowed me to skip this room, that could be okay, too, you know? I could just leave and we could pretend like this wasn't even happening. But if you want to fight to the death, well, that's your decision, my friend. I even got a juicy bomb out of it and access to the secret room where I picked up 3 cents. That's going to fund the war effort against your organization, mister. And to think you're the one who wanted to fight. I just wanted to live in peace and harmony, be a young boy in the 21st century. Young boy in the 21st century is my favorite film of 2014, by the way. But how's our reroll potential looking? Not reroll, sorry, our crystal ball potential looking here. It's looking pretty okay, to be honest with you. We might carry a small, we might have to get a few extra kind of rooms, because I'm assuming we'll get hit, and then, man, Chariot's pretty good too. Which one do we want to roll? We could use the Chariot to get the pill. Empress or Chariot? Okay, you know, I'll tell you what, we'll get the Empress card, we'll use the Empress card against Isaac, take Chariot down to the chest. So pop this right away. I don't like fighting Isaac without a full suite of orbitals. Especially when you have like, oh, we got a key for getting hit there. Thank you very much, Fanny Pack. But technology, you have to be standing right up in his grill to actually hit him. Well, not up in his grill, but you got to be on a straight line to him. Whereas with tears, you can kind of throw him in on the diagonals there. It's unfortunate for us because it puts us in a position where, we might as well use it. Got our spirit heart back. Puts us in a position where, I'm going to get hit again. I'll be honest with you, I kind of forgot what I was even talking about. Sometimes I space out when I'm discussing things as well. I enter kind of like a Walter White-esque fugue state during some of these episodes. And I only recover later. Am I going to get hit again? Okay, thank God we didn't. Please die before you can do like any more damage to me. Okay, we're fine. And you're dead. Now, we actually could make history and get a hard run victory. Not history overall, of course, but history for myself. And we'll open up all these chests. All we need is some good stuff. All we need is stuff. Boop, ba-doo, ba-doo. Well, we can't tell what any of this shit is, so let's go buck wild. Controlled friend, it's okay. Experimental treatment. Well, we seem to be firing even faster. Odd mushroom, that's out of control now. The bean, toot on command, that's pretty bad. Well, I'll be honest, I don't love what we got, but I'm still not 100% sure what we even got out of experimental treatment. I mean, I know what experimental treatment does, but it has variable, oh, that was so bad. It has variable effects that I'm not 100% clear on as of right now. But it might seem like we're in a kind of, oh, that's so bad. It might seem like we're in kind of a dire circumstance here, but I actually happily have to disagree with you on that one, Jim. I'm going to have to say that we're actually in an okay position because we have Crystal Ball. And all we need is Crystal Ball to pay out with a card. Justice, maybe not the exact one I'm looking for, but if Crystal Ball pays out with a Sun card, that might be all we need to really get back from that ledge, my friend, you know, to reference Third Eye Blind, which I like to do at least once per day to keep the doctor away. That was terrible. I'll admit that I was getting a little distracted trying to control controlled friend there. That room did not go super well, but picked up Sack of Pennies, which is going to make all the difference. This actually is the right way to go. Well, you know what? A controlled friend is actually a pretty nice way to deal damage to enemies where you don't want to get up in their face. Like, I don't want to get up in Bloat's face because he has the same kind of directionality to his attacks that I do. So that went very well. Come on, work with me here. I think controlled friend might actually deal more damage than our technology shots, to be honest with you. Which maybe means that we're going to try to use controlled friend as... Oh, that was not very good. We're going to try to use controlled friend as like a Ludovico technique thing or something. I hate that telepills, by the way. It could have just cost us the game, or it could just give us a more difficult journey. Because all we need to do, you know, we still got our crystal ball charge imminent here. Imminent. Imminent. It's imminent. You gotta forgive my sing-songiness, but I gotta give myself some distraction on a run like this. Because otherwise, I'm just gonna freak myself out and die. We gotta teleport. Did this take us any closer to the boss? So this is Dark One. So my strategy for Dark One is mostly just don't get directly below him. If you can stay not directly below him, you're in a pretty good spot. Ooh, that was almost an inconvenient truth there. There we go, one's dead. You know what? Controlled friend is actually doing work for us right here. I'm looking and I'm liking. Now, the question is, can we beat Blue Baby like this? The answer to that question is almost certainly no. But we have a couple of rooms to go. You never know what kind of greatness we could discover. That's the bean. The bean is not that greatness that I'm looking for. Well, this one actually... Oh my god. Instead of using a controlled friend so kind of religiously here, I actually am going to enjoy technology because... For at least the first little bit of this fight, we can hit multiple enemies at the same time. Oh, that's bad. Room's not over yet. Now we'll let Mega Fatty do what Mega Fatty do. Or sorry, we'll let Controlled Friend do what Controlled Friend do. Where's my other, It came out of nowhere. I was killed by nothing. But hey, we did get an unlock there. Did I get any... No, I'm still at 320 items. If you look at Kane, you know, we got a couple of things ticked off there. I enjoyed that run even though we did die. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. At least I didn't throw. And if you did, hey, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. Subscribe if you want to see more in the future. And for now, I'll see you next time. Beep boop.